So we're doing something here we normally wouldn't do, and that's we're using a lot of really expensive shop tools. We try to avoid that as much as possible because not everybody's going to be able to afford what is basically, this ends up being about a $500 rig when it's all said and done, when you buy everything, okay? So that's really pricey for the home mechanic. But for shop mechanics, they need to be able to do this. And for home mechanics, they need to know that this can be done. That's the purpose of what we're doing here. Now, I measured this in our last video. We measured that. We determined we need to ream it. And we also showed that this is basically a 40.98 ream. All right, now that's 41 millimeters, 40.98. What's the deal? Well, we need that little bit in there to give us the press fit. Press fitting requires a very accurate interference, okay, between the parts. All right, so the hole has to be a little bit smaller than what's going in for us to get what we want. A little bit smaller, okay? Once you exceed that one thou, two thousandths of fit, the whole thing is gonna go awry. You're gonna start having degradation of performance immediately. And of course, if it's way too big, then that you don't have enough retention and it's not a press fit at all, it's a slip fit, and you can't do that. That will not work. So we need to be in that Goldilocks zone, and this is what's going to get us there. So let's go ahead and before we start reaming, which we will do in our next video, I want to show you guys something very important, and that is this bike has disc brakes. We are going to be putting oil and solvents up here very shortly. If any of that gets on these pads, they will be ruined. So whenever you're doing something like this, I recommend taking a glove, okay, and putting a glove over it to protect it from all the oil and stuff that's about to get on it.